Yo, Adam Saxon with Guy in a Cube, and in this video, we are going to look at the new app experience in Power BI. Oh my gosh, it's here. If you're finding us for the first time, be sure to hit that subscribe button to stay up to date with all the videos from both Patrick and myself. So before we get into that, I need to lay out the challenge that has been there for apps inside of Power BI. So the problem here is that you could only ever have one app for one workspace. A lot of the feedback from people using Power BI is, look, I want to have multiple apps for a given workspace because I may have a lot of reports in there and I want to serve it out to different audiences. An executive set of reports, and then I've got reports just for maybe the line workers. Usually this came up in two flavors. Either one, people wanted folders with inside of the workspace and also in the app. And by extension, they wanted permissions on those folders, or they wanted the ability to create multiple apps per workspace. So what the Power BI team did was they came out with this audiences concept for apps. So it's not multiple apps per workspace and it's not folders, but it gives you the ability to create views of your workspace that can be controlled through access lists. All right, enough of all this talking. You know, we like to do it here on Guy in a Cube. Let's do what? Let's head over to my computer. Before we get into the new experience, I want to show what the old experience looked like from an app perspective. So I've already got an app published. So if I go ahead and hit update app, we're going to go in and this is the old experience. So we've got the setup navigation permissions. And what you'll see here is, hey, a new and improved app experience is available and you can upgrade your existing apps. This is as of the recording in September 2022. The new app experience is currently preview, and so you have this option to upgrade. My expectation is that once it's generally available, all apps will be upgraded. So let me go ahead and just jump over and let's just go create that new experience for you. So in a new workspace that doesn't have an app published, you'll see this create app. An app is just this view into the workspace, and apps allow for wide distribution, right? So if you have a few users that are just using those reports, I'd recommend you just stick with the workspace. But if you have a large number of users, you know, like 10 or more, and you need to distribute it out there and control who has access, then go ahead and use a published app. And I won't get into licensing, but just know that either they have to be individually licensed as a user, either through Pro or Premium per user, or it needs to be backed by premium capacity for consumption. All right, so let's create the app. And this is the new experience here. So we've got three stages. We've got setup, content, and audience. So let's go ahead and set this up. So I need to add a description. You can play around with the app theme color. You can do a custom logo. You can control who the contacts are and then maybe a support site. So this is exactly the same what it was before. And then to go to the next piece, we'll click on next, add content. And here, this is radically different. It used to be the navigation pane, but now we can just add content. So remember, it's only one app per workspace. So it's not like we can go create another app with different content. So any content you want to include in the app needs to be added here. And then we'll define who can see what in the next step. Let me go and add a few things. So we'll say Adventure Works, we'll do sales report, and then we'll do AS Trace. All right, so now we can see those three items here. The other thing I'm gonna do is I'm just going to add a new section, and you can move these sections around by clicking on this little, I don't know, hamburger, whatever that is. And then we're gonna add a new link. Open that in a new tab, and then we'll add that to the help section. Cool. So now we've got reports and then we've got documentation and help and other resources. This is what we want. And if we, you know, we click on AdventureWorks, it brings up the report. Life is good. All right. So next we're going to go to add audiences. You'll see by default, I've got an audience here and then I can add new audiences. We'll consider this the main audience. So these are the main report consumers. And so what I don't want them to see is this AS trace information. And I want this to be for the sales group. So we'll go and add that in there. And there's some other advanced options. If you want to be able to share the data set, or if you want people to be able to build content, you can go ahead and select that if you want. Then I'm gonna create a new audience. If I right click on this, you can say move left or delete, but I wanna rename this. How do I do that? The only way I could find to do this is just double click on it. If you know of another way to rename it, drop it in the comments below. In this one, we don't wanna see the sales information. So they're only gonna see the AS trace information. And this is going to be my IT group. Now, everything is set up the way I want. So I've got two different audiences that are managed by two different access lists. The people in the central IT will only be able to see the trace and the help. The other folks can be able to see the sales report, but not the trace. So let's go and publish that app. All right, so the app is there. So now let's go over to John Doe. So John Doe is going to be my report consumer. So he should be able to see the sales reports. What we're going to do is go to apps and we're going to add the app. And bam. Now in this app, we can see we don't see the AS trace information because John didn't have permission because he's only in the sales group. Perfect. That's what we want to see. So now let's go over to someone that's in that IT audience. So Michael here is in the IT audience. So let's go and add the app there. And here we can see that Michael can only see the AS trace information and help, but he doesn't see the sales information. That's bananas. Seriously, like this is something that has been asked for in the community for a long time. This multiple app per workspace experience. Even though it's a single app, it does give that feel that you can break up content by persona or by role. Now, the big thing that this reduces, what I've seen other people do in the past, is they would duplicate content to different workspaces to get that capability. So now you don't have to duplicate content. You can keep it in one spot, and now you can create these different roles inside of the apps to allow for broader distribution in a meaningful way. All right, I wanna hand this over to you. What do you think? Did this just blow your mind or is there something more you're looking for? Let me know in the comments below. I'd love to hear it. If you like this video, be sure to give it a big thumbs up, smash it if you so desire. If it's your first time here, hit that subscribe button. And as always, from both Patrick and myself, thank you so much for watching. Keep being awesome and we'll see you in the next video.